on some basic concepts of chemistry, numericals. In continuation with what we learnt of numericals previously, now let us welcome to this video lesson on the numericals of the chapter some basic concepts of chemistry. Now let us look into the numericals. Determine the empirical formula of an oxide of iron which has 69.9% iron and 30.1% dioxygen by mass. So they have given us the data. What is the data given? It is oxide of iron, that's a clue given to us, which has the data contains 69.9% iron and 30.1% dioxygen by mass. So with this data, what we are supposed to find out? We need to calculate the empirical formula. What is this empirical formula? It is a simple formula which gives us the ratio of the exact components present in a given compound. Say supposing glucose. What are all the components present in glucose? Carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. So this is the composition that is present. And what would be this empirical formula of this glucose? CnH2n then O. This will be the formula. So that n we need to find out. Whatever that n, if we find out, then it becomes molecular formula. So empirical formula tells us the components ratio present in a particular compound. So here we are asked to calculate only the empirical formula. To find out the empirical formula, first what we need to do is we need to make the tabulated column and go ahead with our calculation by considering the given data to us. So what should be the title of all this column? Let me just give you the idea. The first element, the first column should contain element. Second column will be percent by mass of the element, both of which is given in the problem. Then atomic mass, that we should be knowing it. Then relative number of moles that we need to calculate. Then we need to calculate the simple ratio by the number of moles that we will be calculating. So to fill this table, first we should have calculated this content. And finally, we need to convert it to its whole number. Now, converting it to whole number is also the standard form. As I go with the solving of the problem, I will explain this to you. Now, let us start filling the contents which I have already done for easy understanding. Element is iron and oxygen. Percentage by mass of iron given to us, as you can see, is 69.9% that we have written here, and oxygen that we have written here 30.1%. Now what is the atomic mass of iron? This we should be already knowing it. In fact, it's better that you practice to remember the atomic mass of few important elements that you can find it in the periodic table. Now 55.85 is the atomic mass of iron and 16 will be the atomic mass of oxygen. Now we need to calculate the number of moles. How to calculate the number of moles? Formula to calculate the number of moles will be W by M. What is W? Given mass. What is M? The molecular mass. In this case, it is the atomic mass. So therefore, when we calculate 69.9, divided by 55.85, it gives the value as 1.25 moles. Similarly, the given mass is 30.1 divided by the molecular mass of oxygen 16, it gives the value as 1.88 moles. Now, after we calculate the number of moles, in this column where it is titled as simple ratio, what we should do is, of all the values that we will be getting here, we have to divide this number of moles by the lowest number of moles that we get in this particular column. In this case of our example, we are having only two elements, iron and oxygen. not necessarily that all the numericals will have only two elements. It can be more than two elements also. So in that case also you need to follow the same thing. What is that same thing? You have to take the lowest number of moles from this particular column and that you have to put it below, and above you should take the number of moles of that each particular constituent and you have to divide it. So in this case, between 1.25 and 1.88 moles, you know that 1.25 moles is the lower value. So that we are dividing for the same number value here. So 1.25 divided by 1.25, that gives the value as 1. Now we have to divide this 1.88 by the lowest value, that is 1.25. We get the value as 1.5. Now after doing this, what is the next thing that we need to do? We have to take the simplest whole moles ratio. The simplest whole moles ratio is also in the standard form. If it is 1 mole, it is always the simplest whole number moles ratio will be 2. If it is 1.5, it is 3. If it is 2, then if the simple ratio is 2, then simplest whole number moles ratio will be 4. And if it is 2.5, then this value will be 5. So that standards are already been fixed. We need to just use that. So now we got this value. This will be the ratio in which the constituents that will be present as per the oxide of iron. So Fe2, this Fe is having the final value here as 2. How did we arrive at this? We calculated this. How did we calculate this? We first calculated this and took the lowest number from this column and we divided the entire number of moles by that. How did we come for getting the value of moles? We divided the given mass percent by the atomic number of the constituent. How did we do this? This percentage by mass would be given in the problem. This, in case if they give in the problem, fine. Majority of the time they don't give this value. That means you need to remember the atomic mass of few important elements. So now, amalgamating all of them, what is that we are getting here? It is Fe2, then O is 3. So the empirical formula in this case is Fe2O3. In fact, for this problem, this also is the molecular formula. So if you do such type of calculation in the exam and the tests, you will be getting complete 2 marks.